2010. So with this brief introduction, may I now invite Dr. Ramulu for his talk on the topic, Eco-Friendly Controlled Blasting Techniques for Rock Excavation of Underground Metros and Infrastructural Projects. So over to you, Dr. Ramulu.
Thank you, Dr. Sir, my colleagues from CSIR and CIMFER, and speakers from the organizations, Shri Jairama Sir, and one more speaker from BRO, Sudhir Kumar Sir. Thank you. Good afternoon, each and everyone. Yeah, is it presentation form, full screen?
Yes, it's clear.
Yeah, is it full screen? No, I can go ahead now.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you. The topic of this presentation is eco-friendly blasting techniques for rock excavation of ground, underground and infrastructural projects. Now, this presentation focuses on two important success stories of CSIR CIMFER on application of controlled blasting technology for construction of metro rail projects and for construction of Navi Mumbai International Airport. The rock excavation is an essential operation for construction of civil and infrastructural projects, and blasting is the best alternative for that. But urban infrastructural projects like metros consider blasting as the last resort due to its destructive nature. Therefore, the biggest challenge for any blast designer is to convert this destructive operation into a constructive one. The major challenges of urban blasting are to conduct blasting in the vicinity of sensitive structures, to contain the side effects within the safe limits, and to yield desired output, that is 400 to 500 meter cube per day in most of the metro projects. See, normally to contain ground vibrations, the controlled blasting of pre-splitting is adopted. We have also adopted this technique in almost all metro stations. You can see clear crack between the holes and the half cast of high wall. The pre-splitting was conducted, one of the case studies, let me explain, the pre-splitting was conducted at a cantonment station of BMRCL. The threshold limit fixed was 10 mm per second, as the dominant frequency is in the range of 20 to 25 hertz. But the pre-split blast generated a PPV of 14 to 16 mm per second, which is more than the threshold limit. Therefore, it was felt that there should be some alternative controlled blasting to contain the ground vibrations. To fulfill this aim, CSIR CIMFER developed two ultra-controlled blasting techniques to contain ground vibrations and to enhance productivity. They are, one is modified pre-splitting technique, and the second one is shock relief blasting technique. The first one is for as a controlled blasting, and the second one is for production blasting. So the modified pre-split blasting includes large diameter holes of 100 mm, and small diameter jackhammer holes are drilled in between the large diameter holes. They are line drill holes actually. This pre-split blasting is designed to generate vibration limits less than 10 mm per second. So when the small diameter holes are charged with mild charge with DF and fired, the large diameter hole is ruptured, as it is shown here. The cracks towards both opposite ends are shown here. And there is a clear pre-split, pre-shear we have seen. You can see the three stages here. This is the charging stage. After blasting, the clear crack is visible here. And the half barrels of large diameter as well as small diameter, you can see clearly in this picture. This has reduced the PPV levels by 40% to 40% in comparison to normal pre-splitting. And at a distance of 8 to 12 meters, the vibration level observed was 4 to 7 mm per second. Therefore, this modified pre-splitting is suitable to conduct in the near field locations. The second one is shock relief blasting. This consists of a reinforced concrete ball placed at the bottom of the hole. When the explosive is initiated, the shock waves are traveled to the ball and reflected towards all the directions except bottom. This results in minimum damage to the bottom and maximum breakage to the rock mass. This is very favorable in terms of reducing the damage to the foundation and to the sides and maximizing the blast fragmentation. You can see the fragmentation here with normal blast. The mean fragment size is 870 mm and with shock relief blast, it is 265 mm. The fine fragmentation is observed with the application of shock relief blasting. See, the vibration intensity was reduced by 60% and it was less than 10 mm per second at 8 to 10 meters distance. And this has reduced the foundation damage by 80 to 85%. It is up to 6 to 10 centimeters only, in contrast to 40 to 60 centimeters with normal blasting. The damage was assessed by the ultrasonic pulse velocity meter. This resulted in huge cost and time savings in backfill concreting, which is in tune of tens of crores, which is an opportunity cost. So every metro station, every urban station, even thermal power plants also can save tens and hundreds of crores by applying these techniques, by avoiding the foundation breakage, foundation damage. Now the conclusions: effective pre-splitting is achieved by modified splitting. Main objectives of ground vibration control was achieved by modified pre-splitting and shock relief technique. Shock relief blasting reduced the foundation damage by 80 to 85% and improved the fragmentation by 69 to 70%. The controlled blasting methods developed by CSIR SIMFER improved both safety as well as productivity. Now, the second technology applied for construction of international airport at Navi Mumbai. Let me explain you. The maximum capacity of present Mumbai International Airport is 52 million passengers per annum. Presently, it is handling 45 MPPA, but by 2030, it is projected to grow 100 MPPA. Therefore, the CIDCO proposed a new airport to cater the increased traffic, air traffic, in 10 years. So the proposed capacity of this Navi Mumbai airport is 60 MPPA. This is the plan diagram of this proposed Navi Mumbai airport. This is the largest greenfield airport and first multi-airport system in metro cities in India. Well, the challenges for construction of this Navi Mumbai airport is haphazard stone quarrying along the Ulve Hill in the past, and there are 8 villages with a lot of hutments within the 100 meter range. The blast fragment size required should be 300 to 700 mm to use it for refilling of the blasted area, the blast area, the same airport area. As a strategy to reduce contained ground vibrations and fly rock, this blast zone blasting area is divided into 4 categories. Within 50 meters, it is a buffer zone which requires silent blasting, like by using non-explosives like plasma blasting, etc. 50 to 100 meters is categorized as cautious blasting zone, which requires full muffling and electronic detonation system. 100 to 300 meter zone is called as controlled blast zone, which requires nonal initiation system with limited holes. And beyond 300 meters, it is normal blast zone. So these are the blast design parameters derived for different zones for getting the desired output in terms of fragmentation as well as controlled vibration and fly rock. The fragmentation of each and every blast was also analyzed by StataFOS software, and the mean fragment size is falling within the range of 300 to 700 mm. Now the conclusions are, the major challenges of ground vibration, air overpression and fly rock are overcome by adopting site-specific controlled blasting technique. It is required to apply electronic delay initiation system for the structures within 100 meters and a non-electric initiation system for structures at 100 to 300 meters. The desired rock fragmentation size of 300 to 700 meters was achieved by optimizing blast design and the charge factor ranging from 0.55 to 0.7 depending on the rock strength. Thank you very much. Now I would like to show some quality videos regarding this metro blasting.
Dr. Ramu, should we play from here?
No, sir. No, it is over, sir. It is over. Now I can see. I think you can see the video now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is the billing and charging operation in one of the metro station. Explosive charging. This is muffling system, three-tiered muffling system with wire mesh, sandbags, and blasting mats. This is full covering of blast holes by heavy blasting mats. This is the inspection of pre-split blast. The blasted BMRCL. At launching shop. You can see no fly rock in all the blasts. So that is required. Zero tolerance of fly rock is required for conducting any blast in urban, that is metro blast. This is a blast at the SEEP station of MMR. So this is one of the milestones of TBM launching after rock excavation by controlled blasting. Thank you.
Yeah, my Sikha, just 1 minute. Now I will, because it is not in the plan, but the one of our scientists, decorated scientist of CSIR Simpher, Dr. Murari Prasad Rai, who is also technology awardee and lot of laurels in his credit, and he is associated with many projects of CSIR Simpher, will show some video of Mumbai airport because he is also working there. So I request MP Rai to play some videos of Mumbai airport, Nayi Mumbai airport.
Good afternoon, everybody. This side, I am MP Rai, and I am just showing some good video we have conducted at Nayi Mumbai International Airport site for controlled blasting, taking the village are very near to the airport site. So we are considering all the safety measures so that there should not be any flare-ups, which will give problem to the villagers. So just in next 6 to 7 video, it is already in the YouTube. So I would like to show those video.
Okay.
CSIR CMFR has developed and executed controlled blastings for land development work for Navi Mumbai International Airport by cutting a 92-meter high, 1.2-kilometer wide and 2.5-kilometer long Ulve Hill and diversion of Ulve River by constructing a 120-meter wide and 3.2-kilometer long diversion channel. The present video is showing the controlled blasting conducted for land development work at Navi Mumbai International Airport project site. Controlled blasting for flattening of Ulve Hill at Navi Mumbai International Airport project site. Controlled blasting conducted near densely populated area at Navi Mumbai International Airport project site. Controlled blasting for land development work to construct Navi Mumbai International Airport. Controlled blasting for preparation of runway at Navi Mumbai International Airport project site. Demolition of mega cliff created by haphazard mining in past for construction of Navi Mumbai International Airport. Land development work for development of city using controlled blasting technique in highly populated area of Ulve in Navi Mumbai.
Thank you, Dr. M.P. Roy. Now, Sikha, over to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. M.P. Roy, for showing the videos to our viewers. And also, thank you, Dr. Ramulu, for your talk and taking us through the controlled blasting techniques adopted for construction at metros and airports. So, let us move further to the webinar. Our next speaker in the session is Mr. Jayarama H., who is Project Director of Norzel and Toubro and Shanghai Terminal Engineering Corporation joint venture, and has successfully completed business assignments in project management, design management, and commercial management. He has nearly 30 years of experience in project management of construction industry and has earlier headed Chennai and Kolkata underground metro rail projects. So, Mr. Jayarama is instrumental in implementation of CSIR Simfer controlled blasting technology in Mumbai Metro Rail Project UGC07. So, with this brief intro, may I now invite Mr. Jayarama for his talk on the topic role of CSIR Simfer controlled blasting techniques for safe and productive rock excavation at Mumbai Metro Rail Project UG3-7. So, over to you, Mr. Jayarama.
Yeah. Good afternoon, Director Mr. P.K. Singh. Good afternoon, Dr. Ramlu and our other colleagues. Good afternoon to all. It is my privilege to be part of this 80 years of success stories of CSIR Simfer. Dr. Ramlu, can you put the presentation? Okay, I will put that. Okay. Give me a minute. Sir, can you see the presentation?
No, sir.
Hello?
The presentation is not yet visible.
So I will upload, Jayaram sir.
Okay, 1 minute. Okay, you told you will upload. That's why I thought. Please upload. Yeah, I know. Okay, sir. Please, next slide. Sir, this our project consists. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes.
Yeah. The project consists of three underground stations connected with the twin tunnels of 5.8 meter diameter. Tunneling length is around 7 kilometers. All three stations are around 20 to 25 meter deep in a densely populated area, and one ramp is also a cut and cover station. And mid shaft between MIDC to Maralnaka, this is the blue dot, which is a shaft for launching of TBM. And the main feature is this metro line is being constructed in the densely populated area, where initial stages of the construction project, there were a lot of opposition from the local population on the construction of the metro, and also the noise pollution due to the piling activities. Next slide. So we were looking for the how to face the challenges faced by the local population to go ahead with the, we need to control the complete this project on time. And in this excavation, especially rock excavation, was a big uphill task for us, considering we need to do this job in 12 to 18 months time, depending on the stations. So we were exploring many options like going for chemical blasting and other mining equipments and other excavators, all these things. Then we thought there are similar methodology being and we got the information, also the knowledge from other metros, and that Simpur is doing an excellent job in other metros in guiding and the contractor to achieve the productivity as well as controlling the blasting, controlling the vibrations in the to minimize the damages in the adjoining structures. Next, sir. These are the four locations where we have done the drilling and blasting works. The best thing is Simpur. This go next. No issue. This is the middle shaft where we lowered our TBM for the purpose of tunnel drag, for the purpose of tunneling, where our tunnel boring machines were lowered and we started the tunneling from this place. These are some of the photographs where the controlled blasting is adopted. You can see the adjoining hutments and some adjoining structures. In fact, these are all what you call not a pakka house also. Our challenge was to minimize the vibrations here. Vibrations to the level of less than 5 ppa. But Dr. Ramalu and his team could give the design on time. He could handhold our team to what type of blasting material we have to use, what type of monitoring we should do, all these things. Simpur team could ably guide us to minimize the impact due to PPV. PPV has all levels were achieved less than 5 ppb, and also there are no vibrations felt in the adjoining structures. And we could also achieve around 300 to 500 cubic meters of production per day. And there were no, in fact, initial stages of the project when there was a blasting, drilling blasting was happening, there were local population, they took objections also. Then we could say, yes, Simpur is involved in this project to guide us to and to have a safe blasting of drilling, controlled drilling blasting operations. So the concerns of the local populations were also met with, and it is and successfully done while executing also. See, these are all the photographs where we have done controlled blasting below the structures, below the decking where the traffic is going on. This is the temporary bridge which you can see for the purpose of traffic diversion. And below that, we have done successfully controlled blasting. Thank you. And what in succinctly what we can say is without the Simpur and Dr. Ramalu's efforts, we might not have completed this project on time. Now project is around 90% done. And in this, since it is a bottom up construction, the excavation up to around 25 meter deep was a challenging task for us. But Dr. Ramalu and his team, they were giving the design, which was being, initially it was approved by the general consultants and our own design consultants also. And they were hand-holding us to minimize the PPVs, minimize the vibrations and also fly rocks. The best thing is the geologists posted by Simpur, they were acting as what the control point to maintain safety. So in all, around 2.5 lakh of cubic meter of excavation we have done in a span of around 15 to 18 months, and without any what you call injuries to the any people, and it was safely done. And we in this project we convey our hearty congratulations and also to our to the Simpur management for supporting us to deliver the project on time. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Jairam sir, for your valuable feedback.
Thank you.
And thank you, our director sir. I'm grateful to you, sir, for providing me the opportunity to present in this platform.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you.
And I would just point out here that I am very happy to see your last slide, which is now on presentation. Hand-holding approach. We own you. You own us.
Yes.
Because Simpur logo or CSR logo is visible there. Great.
Yeah, correct.
Thank you very much, sir, for your acknowledgement.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. It is a privilege to work with you. And congratulations on your 80th success story. All the best to you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Over to Sikha.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the talk and informing us about the collaboration. So we'll move further. And our next speaker in this session is Dr. Aditya Rana, who is as a scientist in CSIR Super Dhanbad. And he has made notable contributions in the field of rock blasting and infrastructure engineering. Recently, Border Roads Organization
away from the mic. You should be a little bit away from the mic.
Am I audible enough now?
You are audible. Presentation is not visible.
So shall I begin?
It's not in presentation mode. Full screen mode.
Yeah. On behalf of CSIR Central Institute of Mining and Fuel Research, I will be presenting the current practices of controlled blasting implemented by our institution at various strategic roads and railways across the country. As you might be well aware that the construction pace of transportation elements such as roadways, railways, airports, etc. in hilly terrain is pretty slower than plain area because considerable amount of rock excavation is involved. In planar areas, we are having 8-lane, 16-lane expressways, but it is even very difficult to construct a 4-lane highway in Himalayan hilly terrain. Similarly, we are having broad gauges railway network in the planar area, but in Himalayan terrain, we still strive on narrow gauges at many places. The reason behind the slow progress is considerable volume of rock excavation and associated slope stability for hill transportation. Forest clearances needs to be taken from many ministries. Due to the extreme climatic conditions in Himalayan hilly terrain, both in northeastern and northwestern part, we are having very limited working seasons. Further, it is difficult to avail construction materials like bitumen, cement, blasting materials at remote Himalayan terrain. Many remote hill locations and points of strategic significance still remains to be connected because of aforesaid reasons. CIMFER has taken many initiatives in recent years to enhance the pace of strategic roads and railway construction. In the country, we have signed an agreement with Border Roads Organization. In the recent year, CIMFER helped Mizoram PWD to widen the Dudlung-Lytton Highway. We are associated with land development work of Navi Mumbai International Airport. In recent times, we reinitiated the slope stabilization work of accident-prone Konkan Railway. We are also associated presently with widening of and double laning of Eastern Central and Eastern Coastal Railways. We are also excavating rock mass and providing blast designs for railway bridge, pier and abutment construction. Nevertheless, we are also providing demolition blast designs and implementing demolition blast so as to remove the dilapidated old bridge structures so that new bridges may be constructed in their places. We signed our first agreement in November 2018. After that, Border Roads willingly extended our agreement for a period of 5 years. Much of the work of Border Roads is in hilly terrain. Many of their projects, except Project Chetak, which is in sand dunes. All of the projects are in Himalayan terrain. So as to construct the road, they need to cut formation cutting. For formation cutting, they need to do rock blasting. So objective of our work are to enhance the pace of construction without compromising safety of border roads people and machines, training the border roads officers, and after every visit, we submit a standard operating procedure to BRO project so that their engineers can implement similar control blasting designs for their roads. The tenure of our agreement is 5 years. 1 year has already elapsed. The agreement is proposed to be extended by another period of 5 years after completion of 6 years. The challenges which we faced were life intimidating landslides, particularly in Pithoragarh project Hirak in Uttarakhand. We were also stuck due to snowfall in project Vijay and project Beacon located in Kargil and Srinagar respectively. Once our vehicle was also pelted with stones in Gandharbal, Jammu and Kashmir. As most of the roads of border roads are located at remote locations, it takes us 5 to 6 days sometimes so as to reach these sites. And most of the roads does not have a metal layer because of extreme climatic conditions. Bitumen gets washed away during rainy season or while cutting off snow. So long distance journeys on such kind of roads take a serious toll on vertebral column. Altogether, we have visited 20 roads in past 1 and 5 years. As per the newspapers, these roads are having high strategic significance. At some locations, the inclusion of Chinese troops were noticed and reported in newspapers in Arunachal Pradesh. We are also associated with border roads in construction of alternative alignment of a strategic significant road, that is NPD road. And this is an alternative alignment of the road for which Kargil war was fought. In Kargil war, Pakistan tried to sever the connectivity between Srinagar and Leh by destroying the NH-1D. After the Kargil war, Indian government pondered and decided to have an alternative strategic alignment for this important road. We are also proposed to visit Galwan Valley, where clashes with China took place in last year. The reasons for poor progress of border roads can be characterized that sometimes explosive gets blown out because of improper blast designs and then implementation. This leads to repetitive drilling and blasting cycles. Hence, much time is consumed without progress. This phenomena has been observed at many projects of border roads. Jamming of drill roads has also been observed at many projects. Poor geology and accidents associated with rockfall and landslides has been observed at many projects. You might be amazed to know that accident rate and mortality rate of border roads people is much more than Indian Army people. At this particular location, around 10 to 15 border roads officers have died because of rockfall. This location is shown in photograph. Another reason of poor progress is after the construction of initial alignment, many structures of Indian Army and local people have inhabited the roads nearby. So a greater control of fly rock, vibration, sound and is required. We are providing blast designs to BRO for solving this problem also. As per the reports received from different projects of Border Roads Organization, they have confirmed that the blast designs and implementations provided by CSIR SIMFER has enhanced the progress of strategic roads by 35 to 40%. Additional Director General of Border Roads also wrote to our Honorable DG CSIR, and he confirmed that the blast designs of CSIR SIMFER were quite helpful in enhancing the progress of border roads. DG CSIR also wrote an appreciation letter to us, and he tweeted a video of DG BRO where he is acknowledging the efforts of SIMFER in an interview. This video was tweeted to Prime Minister Office and Defence Minister Office. This is how CISIR SEMFER is contributing in eco-friendly rock excavation for BRO. This particular blast was conducted recently in Arunachal Pradesh, where we are constructing a new road to a disputed place. As most of the border roads are located in remote locations where there is no inhabitation in and around 10 km for fresh cutting, so no control on fire rock is desired. Economy is highly desirable because they don't want to excavate a 40 to 50 meter high hill. They just want to drill from the alignment and want to drench off the rock mass in the adjoining river valley. This is the widening blast implemented by CISIR SEMFER at an Uttarakhand road along the China border. Apart from border roads, we are also assisting other civil agencies such as PWD, NHIDCL in construction of roads. This particular case study is from Dutlang Litton Road, Mizoram. The initial alignment was constructed by border roads in 1960s. Then in 20 years, considerable settlement took place near the alignment. And when rewinding operations were pursued by border roads, the local objected to uncontrolled drilling and blasting vibrations and sound. So this work could not take place. Then this road was given to local PWD. Mizoram PWD recently approached SEMFER so as to have blast designs for controlling blasting vibration and sound. This particular rock ledge was to be excavated for widening the road to the desired width. This was the control blast design implemented by our institute. And strong, stable slopes open to traffic can be seen in this photograph. Apart from this, we are also associated in construction of various highway tunnels of strategic and infrastructural importance. We were associated with Jaipur Development Authority for construction of twin tunnels. We provided blast design so that shattering effect does not come in the twin tunnels. We also provided rock support system designs to Jaipur twin tunnel. Nevertheless, we also provided blast designs and support system designs at Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Chennai Nashri Tunnel in J&K. This particular tunnel is longest roadway tunnel and is of greater strategic significance. This tunnel has reduced the travel time to 2 hours to J&K. Further, many points of landslides, snowfall and avalanche have been removed. Hence, this alignment is providing all weather connectivity to Jammu and Kashmir now. We are also associated with Konkan Railway construction, particularly stabilizing the accident prone slopes using controlled blasting technique. Many accidents of rail derailments have been reported in last decade. The boulder used to fall, the landslide used to occur on the existing railway track leading to railway's derailment, as shown in these photographs and newspaper cuttings. One can very easily say, easily see the wedges susceptible to prone and failure over this railway track. Before getting associated with SEMFER, Konkan Railway deployed various geotechnical measures such as installing HSBN wires, retaining walls, rail catchments. However, none of these geotechnical measures served the purpose. The retaining wall failed and other geotechnical measures were also severed. We determined the rock mass properties. We modeled the three-dimensional model of existing slopes and observed that the factor of safety is 0.91, indicating that the slope is very susceptible to failure. Then we decided to excavate the adjoining rock masses in such a manner that no rock fragments arrive on the railway track. Otherwise, the railway traffic would have stopped and resulted in considerable damage to of revenue to Konkan Railways. Hence, the blasts were designed in two stages. In stage one, it was mainly a production blast. A pit was created, leaving a 1.5 meter high and 2 meter wide wall towards the railway track. This wall prevented the rock mass from coming down the railway track. These were the blast design parameters for this trench or pit blasting. In the stage two blasting, the ledge was blasted in the direction opposite to railway track. Here I am showing some videographs of the blast conducted at the site. This is particularly a production blast or pit blasting. A wall has been left in production blast so as to prevent the rock mass through towards the railway track. Then the ledge was blasted in controlled manner without any rock fragment arriving on the railway track. This video is of Eastern Central Railway. The factor of safety in this manner was increased to 1.71, indicating very high slope stability and poor chances of slope failure. Similarly, we are also assisting railways in excavating piers, abutments for Southeastern Railways in Bano, in Jhansi. We are also associated with demolishing the old dilapidated bridges, particularly in Bengal and Bihar region from where the railway was started by Britishers. The railway bridges are 150 years old. So for double laning purposes as well as so as to reduce the chances of accidents, new bridges are to be constructed by demolishing old bridges. So we are constructing new bridges, demolishing old bridges at these particular sites. Some videographs. Thank you for patiently listening to me, and do visit us on our institutional website. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rajendra, for taking us the journey of control blasting for border road construction and railway construction. Our next speaker is Mr. Prakash Kumar. Mr. Prakash Kumar is an Indian Engineering Service Officer presently posted in Guwahati, and he has completed his M.Tech in Soil Mechanics from IIT BHU. Presently in Guwahati, he is responsible for reviewing the roads under construction in northeast sector of Border Roads Organization. He has also monitored the effects of simpler controlled blasting technique on the construction progress of Kargil Road. So with this brief introduction, may I now invite Mr. Prakash Kumar for his talk. Over to you, Mr. Prakash Kumar.
Good evening to the director, sirs, and the scientist of the CSIR and the CMFR. So I am Prakash Kumar, I'm an executive engineer of the Border Road organization. The Border Road organization is constructing the road in the far flung and the remote areas to develop the infrastructure in the to the local the inhabitants and construct the road for the army the vehicle to move in the forward areas. The Border Road organization is facing the problem for constructing the road, especially in the hard stretch where our progress is not up to the desired level. So BRO decided to take the service of the CMFR, which is expert in the field of the drilling and the blasting. Accordingly, a memorandum was signed between the BRO and the CSIR, the CMFR, and the team of the CIFM, the CMFR, visited the BRO the sector. At the Kargil, so since I was there at the Kargil, so I was also associated with the the memorandum and accompanied the team of the CMFR under the doctor Aditya Rana. So he visited the different roads of the Kargil. So namely, the first road is the Sonam to Bridge Gurugudo Chitar Forward, which is located in the Badalik sector. And second is the Kargil Yoma, which is also going to the forward area to the Pakistan and the border. And third road is the Nimu Padam the Darcha Road, which is the third link between the Himachal Pradesh and the Leh. The team of the CMFR visited the Kargil site where our works were going on. He first studied the our methodology, what we are facing the difficulties. After seeing our methodology, he suggested some improvement in our working for the formation cutting in the hard rock area. For that, he planned the two visits. The first in the first visit, he gave the classroom to teaching of our staffs so that he can be aware of the design of the blast and the use of the free face concept and the control the blasting. Can you hear me, sirs? So could you hear me, sir?
Yes.
Let's go. I'm going to share.
Yes, it is
audible. Just we are sharing the presentation, sir. Just 1 minute, sir. Sir, is presentation visible to you, sir?
Yes, it is visible, but make it in presentation mode. Full screen, you make it. Yes, go ahead.
Sir, is it visible and audible to all of you, sir?
Yes, yes, it is visible, audible, but make it in a full screen.
Full screen, sir.
चलिए ठीक ठीक है
तो अनऑडियो ओके सर
यस यस आगे बढ़िए
दिस इज द साइट ऑन द ग्राउंड डॉक्टर आदित्य राणा इज देयर It is on the road of the Kargil-Yuma road, which is going to the Pakistan border. Here, there was a curve where widening was required. So this is the site of the Kargil-Yuma road. The requirement of the BRO is that we should achieve and the maximum the output and reduce the construction of the road. In the hard rock portion, what happens, the shooting stones comes and it causes the injuries to the men and the machines, and many incidents has occurred in the past. And being the government organization, we are constructing the low cost hill roads. So the BRO is especially is the known for the low cost construction of the road in the country. And also there is no much problem of the fly rock in our area, because we are working in the remote and far flung area, so the population density was not so much, so it can be permissible for the fly rock. These are the roads, the Sonam to bridge Titar Ford, which is to located in the Batalik sector, and where fresh formation cutting we are doing. Well, first time this road will be connected to the Titar Forward village. Second is the Nimu Padam to Darsha road. We have already told that this is the road connecting from Himachal to Leh. This is the third link, and another is the Kargil the Yuma road, and where the widening work is going on. They have already explained the visit program of the Simpar team. So he planned in the two visit, phase. In the first phase, they have already told that he gave the theoretical knowledge for the design of the blast and free phase concept and the control the blasting. But in the same visit also, he demonstrated the blasting pattern on the ground.